fall and the time of plenty. When the trees are changing color, I know when to head out to my favorite lakes up in Muskoka. You know why? Because it's tube snap time for smallmouth bass. I'm getting real shallow on these fish. I mean, 3 feet of water. You just gotta dress warm, fish safe, and if it's nice, I'm going. But what I'm gonna do is fish with little coffee tubes on my favorite, I might use the Bass X or maybe the Avid X by St. Croix. 7 foot, 6 foot, six rods, and snap jig. Looking for reaction strikes, exactly the way you fish for walleyes and different things, but it's those smallmouth bass that are ganged up, looking to feed, bulk up for the winter, take advantage of those fish that are schooling up, that have moved shallow. If I get some big fish, fantastic. But this kind of fishing is phenomenal because it could be fish after fish after fish, just having some action and warming you up on a cool October day. So let's go out, find those little grass patches, sand, rock edges, maybe some weed, and catch some bass with those little coffee tubes. And maybe it'll warm me up and I'll get some coffee later. Let's go have some fun. Now, it's a mistake making long casts when you're doing this because you got a little bit of stretch on that fluorocarbon and you want to dissect those spots in front of you. So small pitch in front of the boat till you find fish. Constantly on the trolling motor, going slow. Watch the tube go down, a little snap. Real simple stuff, real simple. Little snap. You'll know right away. That little St. Croix will tell you ding, or else you just feel that sensation of mushiness or something different. Set hook, underhand pitches, search and destroy little smallmouth in the shallows with a coffee tube with a little snap jig in fall. Do it once and you're gonna hooked on caffeine just like these smallmouth. Whoa, what are you? This might be putt. No, big smallmouth. Oh boy. Wow. Wow, did he eat that? Holy moly, dude. Did he pound that? He likes going under the boat and hiding, hey? I like to go under the boat and hide. Let's see. Oh, that's a good fish. Whoa, oh, oh, come here, Karl. Oh, there he is. Nice one, boy, nice one. Again, it's fall. And it's a time of plenty. Plenty of fun, I'd say. Look where he got it there. Look at that. You think he wanted that? He got that little coffee tube right in the top there. Let off, and there he goes. I'm gonna put a few in the box for some pictures, but that's what I'm talking about right there. You know, snap jigging. 5 feet of water, find that old brown cabbage, you know, in your favorite little cottage lakes here in Northern Ontario, and you're gonna catch them. It's a very simple technique, you know? You see me doing it with hair jigs and stuff for walleye, where I'm throwing out on edges, letting it fall, tick, doom. But these, it's almost, they're grabbing it on the bottom. Because I'm lifting up and all of a sudden there's a fish there. I felt one small fish do the traditional tick, so the tube's falling. And these fish, it seems like, as soon as it falls in the bottom, they come up to take it, lift up, they're already there. As for rods, I'm gonna show you the Avid X. I'm using the 7 foot medium power with that little green pumpkin with the bright gold, and I call it bronzy. The smallmouth just love this kind of stuff. And it's with, the Gamma 10 pound edge fluorocarbon, and a very similar one, again, the Avid X, but 6 foot six, medium power. This one I have with the smoke, red and black flake, but with 10 pound braid. When I get into heavier stuff, maybe really close to rocks, or a lot of heavy reeds and weeds and things like that, I'll pick up the braid, because this lake has some tea color stuff, and again, I'm looking for a reaction strike. So I've got options, the 6 foot six and the 7 foot. And the water temperatures start to drop in the fall. The biggest thing is you cannot think that the fish like, oh, they're tuned down. They're not going to bite. They're not going to chase. Are you kidding? They're in a feed mode. We're still in the low 60s, high 50s. Smallmouth bass, especially these northern fish, they adapt. They're used to it. So don't think about, oh, I got to slow right down, maybe finesse presentations. If the conditions call for that, do it. But you want to catch them fast, hard, and heavy like I am, consider that little snap tube in shallower water by sand and reeds and rocks, and you'll have a blast. Yep, wow, look at that. Oh, another good one. Oh my God, my God. Man, are they ever fun, man. I just missed one too, look at him go. Hell, can you beat that? Here he comes. Look at the side of the boat. Oh, man. Oh, man. Do I love smallmouth bass, boy. Do I love smallmouth bass, especially when they cooperate like this. Eating the tube jigs, boy. Oh, yeah. He's got some beef. Look at the color of these fish. That's because the water clarity. It's like tea. Come here, boy. Oh, right into the frable net. And look where he's got it again. Look at that. Look at that. Right at the top of the mouth. A short little pop, and it's out. But look at that little football. Isn't that nice? That's a beautiful little fish. Again, a little picture fish. Take a couple shots, then we'll let them go. Tell me how you're going to beat that. How? That fun of throwing out. That one I felt go boom. And after the first cast, I felt one. And I just knew. I thought, no way. These things are pack hunters this time of year. You catch one, you're fortunate enough the pack is still around. They see something else fall. All they're thinking about right now is autumn. They're thinking about bulking up, throwing the tube. So they chase their buddies, trying to push their buddies out of the way and grab it. Let's hope grandma does that, where one is like, let's go. And I pull up to an area that I know where the fish are, a little pot of them. I put those poles down. I'm not gonna move. So now I can just, it's like having a floating dock where I'm fishing. Pitch out right to those same areas inside the weed, between the rock, and I can just fish. I can focus. Power poles are priceless for me. When I'm shallow water fishing, anything 10 feet or less, those poles are definitely my arsenal. Oh God. Wow. Unbelievable, man. Unbelievable. This is psychotic, man. Wow. Look at him. He's gonna come up. I think I found a little pack of wolves. Wouldn't you say? I'd say. This thing is nice, man. I think he's about the same size as the other ones. Wow, what is, you talk about fun, man. This is just mental fun. Got that open water here. I'm sitting out in about 9, casting up to about 4 or 5. And that whole school of little buggers is there. Oh, another nice one. Look at that. Look at that, man. They're like twins, all these things. Like twins. Look where he's got it. Look at this. Show you a close-up. Look at that. Coffee tube. Things addicted to caffeine. Look at the colors of these fish, too. When you get tea color water. Whoo, look at that hook. Penetration, man. The striking tube jig hooks, man, are sharp. But the different sizes are the key. And what I found right here is I've got an area about 8 feet of water. I'm sitting in 9, casting up to about 5, staying back and just casting to it. I saw some cabbage weed and I missed a fish. So I came out, cast back at it. I found a little pack of wolves. So we'll get back at it. I think my heart rate is almost at peak, and see if we can catch a few more. The thing is, when you're fishing these spots like this, you find those schooling fish, stay back, put the power poles down, make those short pitches right to where you found them. Like whatever's holding those fish there, when they gang up and fall, you know, it's like the feast or famine. You find them, it's a feast. You don't find them, you know what it is, famine. Oh God, wow, wow. School is in session, dudes. School is in session. Look at them. Just gorgeous fish. Just gorgeous. Let's see. Yeah. Oh, yes. Gorgeous little fish. Look at him. Just a beautiful smallmouth bass. We're going to let him go. I know, you're a little monster. Go on. Get. Look at that. 9:43. There's some waypoints I made here from previous times here, but I'm only sitting 4.7 feet of water catching the fish. It's 60 degrees, a little bit of scattered weed and stuff. Not much, but that's the deal. Fish come shallow to feed. You get in there, you're gonna catch them.